Music natin. And then we have learned that not because it has Christian words in it, it is appropriate for the Christian. Not because you have Christian title of it, it is really something that will make you righteous and holy or appropriate for a Christian. Never ever forget that there is a great danger in the Christian world. Why do you think it has a great danger in the Christian world? Ngayon, further question. Bakit sa tingin nyo, ang pinakaunang pinapuntirya ng kaaway ay ang Christian world? Bakit kailangan niya i-distort ang music ng Christian? Because he knows that by this, he could deceive people. Tama? He could deceive people, and by deceiving people, he could also deceive the picture of God. Okay, I hope that you are following with me. It is depicting, it is destroying, distorting the image of God when we proclaim wrong kind of music. Now, what do we need to do with regards to our music? What is very important? Lyrics or music? Both are important. Both are important. It has a very necessary part in music. Always remember that. Now, at this point of time, I would like to ask now if you really have followed me. What is the right rhythm? What numbers? What beat?
1 and 3.
Why is it 1 and 3? According to the physiological rhythm of our heart, of our body. Everything flows with it. Everything that distorts it will distort also the rhythm of the body. Kaya ka mapapasayaw dahil kasi kailangan mong sumayaw. Following so far? Kasi yung rhythm niya ay talagang pangsayaw. And dapat yung music, it's appropriate to the lyrics that we have. When I say, I love Jesus, dapat yung music ko din, yung body language ko will tell that I really love Jesus Christ. Okay? Now, this moment of time, we really need to discern what right kind of music is, because we are in the edge of Earth's history. I'll be sharing to you this afternoon as the last part, a very important dealing that we will be having in these end times. Ayokong sabihin sa inyo na wala tayo sa huling kapanahunan. Because whether you like it or not, the world is expressing, sharing, and telling us that we are already in the end of time. Malapit na talaga. Why do you think that the world is destroying marriage? Because it distorts the image of God. Tama? Why they need to destroy it? Because later on with that one, it needs also to destroy Sabbath. Kung it destroys Sabbath, what do you think comes next? kung may sakailo na, the next thing that will happen is Jesus soon return or Jesus coming. Are you excited with that? Nasa edge na tayo ng Earth Sister, and we really need to brace ourselves with the Word of God, with the truth. And I really love the question of Sir Arnold. Paano kung yung mga nakakatas, they don't teach us these things? I would always like to pursue. It is still our own conviction. Let me tell you, at the end of the day, it is your accountability with the Lord that matters most. Hindi dahil sinabi ko, hindi dahil sinabi ni Sir Arnold, hindi dahil sinabi ni Joshua, hindi dahil sinabi ni Tami, but rather, it is what does said the Lord. That is very important. Okay? So now, I know that you're ready. So before we go on, shall we bow our heads for the prayer? Heavenly Father, one last time I ask for strength. Guide me and direct me to this last important matter and piece of the music series. May we go out from this place never the same again. And another musical warrior as we come to the end of time. Thank you so much, dear God, for hearing and answering our prayers. In Jesus' name I pray. According to what we have studied a while ago or this morning, I would like to ask you, what would happen to music when, these are the things, when it bypasses the frontal lobe, when it hypnotizes the listener, opens the door to his spiritualism, alters the state of consciousness, causes you to release control of your thoughts, enhances gonadotropins, this is somehow with the hormones of sexuality, opens the door to spiritualism, and you sing Christian lyrics to it, what would happen to music? If it bypasses what? From the low, tapos it alters your consciousness, and then it causes you to risk control of your thoughts, and enhances gonadotropins. What would happen to music? And you have Christian lyrics to it. What would happen? The answer? It will also bypass the frontal lobe, hypnotizes the listener, opens the door to spiritualism, alter the consciousness. The state of consciousness causes you to release control of your thoughts, and answers gonadotropins. Why is it so? Bakit ganon? It doesn't matter if you have Christian lyrics to it, with it, if it is just bypassing the frontal lobe, which is the medium in which we connect with God. Our Father, so far, this is very important to understand, because kung na-alter yung state of consciousness natin, can we still reason that the music that we're listening to is right? Not anymore. Kasi it's already shutting down. Wala siyang senses to reason for God. Wala siyang reason kung tama pa ba yung music mo. And I would like you to remember this. Bakit na paano natin alamin natin na pumapatak ng 1-3 ang music rather than 2-4? Because in the 2-4, na pag-aralan natin kanina, it is distorting the sense of consciousness. Pag sinabi mong 2-4, hindi mo na alamin kung nasa ng 1 and the 3. Tama? Kasi susunod-sunod na siya. Tuloy-tuloy lang siya. But rather, when you go, halapin mo yung one, yung first beat, di ba? To God be the glory, great things he done. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, mapatama ng tama. But rather, sa rhythm ng mundo, hindi mo naisipin kasi nahi-hypnotize tayo sa rhythm niya. I hope that you will remember that. It doesn't necessarily mean that we have Christian lyrics to it. It will justify the right kind of music. How about, let me see if you really understand this. If you really catch what we have learned this morning. How about we are singing Alpha and Omega? He is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Now, do we need to listen to it? If it has a wrong rhythm, do we need to listen to it? Not necessarily. Ang kailangan itama ay yung rhythm. You know what? When I heard the original version of Alpha and Omega, ganun talaga, rock and roll siya. Pero bumibilis pa siya if you would notice it. Pero I have heard a choir that sang it. They are all guys. I've seen. Kaya mo pala talaga itama. Ang problema lang ng tao, we usually worship the feeling rather than what will glorify God. Are you following? Kasi ganito yan. Kung ito'y nararamdaman mo lang, ito lang nararamdaman mo, and then we go for it, it will really alter the state of consciousness. Ngayon, hindi mo na ma-reason kung nasa tamang way ka ng music. But rather, when we really need to think, kung talagang nakaka-akmato o talagang nakaka-glorify ko sa Panginoon, we will really be conscious, we will really be cautious. And I hope that that will really speak something to us. And once again, always remember that music is prayer to God. So when we are in the wrong kind of music, what kind of prayer do we have? It's also wrong kind of prayer. Now let me tell you this. I need you to remember these things. Music should be music. It should be M-U-S-I-C. Is it hard to remember? Madali lang to. This is where we are going to sum up things. And meron ako ipaparinig naman music sa inyo. Tell me if it is appropriate with the M-U-S-I-C. Okay? The first one, music should be what? Meaningful, not trivial. Ibig sabihin, dapat talaga, we really need to understand the reason, the main meaning of the music rather than just singing it without knowing kung ano talaga yung meron doon. That makes it trivial. Let me read to you. Godly music will contain lyrics and instrumentation that are full of what? Beauty, dignity, reverence, and simplicity, worthy in the praise of worship and praise and worship of God. Psalm 33 verse 8. Now tell me if the music that I'll be playing is meaningful or trivial. Okay? You discern it for yourself. Pinag-aralan na natin siya on the first part and on the second part. And I know that you can stand on what you believe and what you already have known this morning. Tell me, this music. What is God doing? That same day, start singing praise.
You know, hold your way. How about Freddy's walk-up?
That's a Christian song. Is it meaningful or trivial? What makes it trivial? Yeah. It's the rhythm. And one more thing I would like you to notice. Yung lyrics na sinabi, what if cartoons got saved? Siguro daw si Flintstones ang kakantay niya instead na hallelujah, yabadabaluya. Kasi anong usual lyrics nga kakantay niya? Yabadaba? True. Now, did God die for cartoons? No. He died for you and for me. And then we will make it trivial with this kind of music. Music should be meaningful, not trivial. Always remember that God died for you, not for cartoons. Hindi siya namatay para kay Barbie. Kay Barney. Another guy, sa'yo at sa akin, He died for you and me. How about this song? Meaningful or trivial? Of course, it's trivial. It's obvious. How about this song? Listen to the lyrics, huh? To be like Jesus. happens to be like Jesus, is it meaningful or trivial? It explains itself. Pero syempre, hindi naman lahat ng tamang music natin ay yung ganun lang mellow. Syempre, kailangan din natin na joyful, di ba? Kailangan yung something that will really make us happy, yet we are not distorting the rhythm. How about this song? Untainted, not worldly. Why it needs to be untainted, not worldly? Because the Bible is expressing Romans 12 verse 1 and 2 that we need not to be conformed to the world. Alam niyo yung principle nun? Si Kim Joshua, pag sinabi kong conform siya sa mundo, ibig sabihin, pag nasa mundo siya, hindi makilala na nandun si Kim Joshua. Kasi nagko-camouflage siya sa mundo. Ayaw ng Panginoon na nagko-conform tayo sa mundo, but rather we need to be distinct. We need to be what? Peculiar people. According to 1 Peter 2 verse 9, we are peculiar people. It needs not to be what? Tainted, but rather it should be untainted and not worldly. Pero ginagawa ng mundo, He really wants us to make these things worldly rather than untainted. Godly music will lead us to think in biblical patterns. It will not seek to imitate the world's what? Way. According to Philippians 4 verse 8, whatsoever things are what? True, whatsoever things are. Just, whatsoever things are. Pure, whatsoever things are. Lovely, whatsoever things are. Good, important, there be any virtue, there be any praise. Think of these things. Kung nagkakaroon tayo ng problema sa basis natin sa Bible o sa music, let's go back to Philippians 4 verse 8. You will never get wrong that one. You will never get wrong. How about this one? Gospel workers, standard 57. In their efforts to reach the world, the Lord's messengers are not to follow the ways of the world. Paano to, Brother Robert? Ang nire-reach out namin ay mga worldly people. Ibig ba sabihin nun, ang gagamitin mong music ay worldly din? Para ma-reach out sila. What do you think? Kunwari ganito. Ang pattern ng mundo ngayon ay Christianized siya, pero may worldly touch. Do we really need to follow those principles in order to reach the world? Ano yung prinsipyo ko dati? Ito talaga gina-justify ko, Sir Arnoldan eh. In order to reach the world, I need to be the world. Is it right or wrong? Huh? It is compromising. See, Jesus Christ, He wanted to reach the world, but He needs not to be the world. I need not to come along kaparehas nila. Di ba si Jesus Christ, na ano siya, nabilang siya sa mga makasalanan. Pero nakita nila na si Jesus Christ pa rin yun. Di ba? Now, listen to this. The principle is still right. According to Proverbs 22 verse 6, train up a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. Kung ang nire-reach nating soul ay mga bata pa, kailangan bang ang bigyan natin ng music sa kanila ay yung worldly patterns din? Kasi bata pa sila, hindi pa nila masyado naiintindihan? No! Kasi, in order for them to understand, train a child in the way they should go. Para nang sa gayon, susundan talaga, bakit ang boring naman ng church na to? Kasi nakikita na nila yung distinction. Pero ipakita mo maganda ang tamang music rather than make it so complicated. Okay? Now, tell me, upon this music, is it untainted or worldly? Okay, how about this?
Take me, Jesus, take me now.
What's the problem with the music? Yung rhythm pa rin. Have you noticed the rhythm na yung talagang 2-4? Di ba? Not because it is religious. It is already qualified as religious for us. It's good for us. Remember that. it should be scrutinized very well. Na-imagine nyo ba? May saan itong ginagamit itong music na ito? Sa baptism. Tama? Na-imagine nyo ba baptism nyo gano'n? Nag-arap and all? I surrender all. Come on. Is that the way we should make it? It should not be, no? How about this song?
Jesus Christ, don't study, it don't matter, you ain't even know my level anyway, shut it down. You make moves, you know how to do it, it's a come through.
Okay. Untainted or worldly?
Worldly.
Very obvious, worldly. But have you noticed the lyrics? Have you seen the Jesus Christ there?
Yes.
Diba? There are so many Christian songs that we really need to scrutinize. Kailangan talaga natin i-filter. Kung talagang gusto mong i-present yung best para sa Panginoon, we really need to scrutinize our music because it should be something that would be, what? Appropriate for God. It should be appropriate in the presence of God. Always remember that. How about this song?
Song, what does that mean?
Kailangan yung virtue ay nananatili sa utak natin unceasingly. Hindi siya nagko-compromise. It is not wavering. It is not wavering. How about this?
Ay, wala na pala. Sunod, no? The next one, it should be spiritual, not carnal.
Before I go on that, you know what the previous song? Sino kumanta nun?
Sally
DeFord. What is the religion of Sally DeFord?
Mormons.
Mormons. Can you just imagine the songs of Sally DeFord are very powerful music? Ang nakakalungkot, tayo hindi tayo nakakapag-create ng music natin. Kasi we usually adopt other people. But have you noticed they are proclaiming their religion? Yun nga lang, ang isa lang talaga out of the many songs na meron si Sally DeFord, you like Nephi. Okay? Because yun ang prophet nila ng strength, no? Kaya binapalitan natin yung minsan Samson or David, no? Because that is appropriate. That is appropriate for us. Kahit yung lyrics nila, kahit yung melody nila, harmony nila, it's really appropriate for us. Adventist. Pero ang problema natin, we usually adopt people, we usually adopt music from other churches. Kaya nangyari, hindi na ma-distinguish kung sino Adventist at kung sino hindi.
Now, I would like to confess this.
The singers are not wrong, okay? But rather, yung music ang nagkaroon ng problema. Huwag mong i-have fun with heritage singers. Yeah. We have been fun with that one. But I would like to tell you, not all of their songs are appropriate for us. Okay? Pero alam nyo, yung mga una nilang album, napakaganda. Pero ngayon, ano na yung way nila ng album? Iba na. Very worldly na siya. May taint na siya ng kamunduhan. You would notice na, ang ganda-ganda na simula. Breathe on me. Diba?
Power of God.
Tapos pagdating ng second stanza, pasok ng drum.
I'm ready to surrender to give you all my life.
Is that wrong? The rhythm is wrong, but the song is very powerful. The song is why kailangan lang itama yung mga music. Tama yung rhythm niya. Kasi I believe is if God has created, kung merong counterfeit, meron talaga genuine. Meron talaga genuine. At I believe it is still the best kung meron tayo. Kung anong meron tayo, it's still the best. Tama? I still believe with that. Now, para hindi kayo mawala ng mga music, are you familiar with the Fountain View Academy?
Yeah. Those are very powerful.
Abigail Miller. Yan yung mga songs, yung Neblets. These are the musicians of the Adventists na kung saan they are really proclaiming our gospel. they're really proclaiming our gospel. Spiritual and not carnal. What does it mean by spiritual and not carnal? Pag sinabi ko spiritual, what does it mean? Talaga yung soul mo ay nalilift up. Pag sinabi mong carnal, nabe-bless ka nga pero ang namumove lang yung body mo. Napapasaya ka lang, yung feelings lang ang nagiging okay. That is spiritual, and that is carnal, that is not spiritual. It should really reach the soul, the spirit, rather than the carnal. Kasi pag ang carnal ang na-reach out sa tao, I tell you, na-alter yung state of consciousness. That is why godly music will promote and accompany a lifestyle of godliness and modesty, encouraging the what? The spirit. It will not encourage aggressive or sexual acts or promote carnal behavior, according to 1 John 2:16. How about this song?
You have a mind of my life. I know you had a pass of the chance before, but I wanna tell you now.
How about that song? Is it carnal or spiritual? Eh, can you just imagine, pinapakinggan mo yun sa tenga mo? And then, nandun yung I love you. And then the worst is, kanina niya kinakanta to? Sa Panginoon! And you are singing a carnal song with Jesus once? Who?
Of course, napanood na natin ito kanina, no?
How about this?
Huh? It's English.
Hindi na narinig. Okay. That should be spiritual na. Sorry, no? Wala yung last music natin. But the second to the last is this. It should be inspirational, not degrading. What does that mean? Godly music will be expressive of the peace that accompanies the Christian life. Alam niyo nangyari sa mga worldly music ngayon? Very bitter. Tama? Ang inilalabas, instead na nakaka-inspire ng tao, nakaka-ano nga siya ng emotion. But ang problema natin, yung mga lyrics, yung mga melodies na siya, it's full of bitterness. Nakita mo lang yung pusong ba ito? Ganun. Tingnan niyo yung mga, may mga hugot yung mga music ngayon, yung mga nasa love songs or nasa worldly songs, you will notice that ang ginagawa ng kaawa is that he will make it inspiring in a sense, pero you know what? Pag nadidistort din naman yung buhay Kristiyano, it is also degrading. It is also degrading. How about the song? Wala akong maisip eh. Wala akong maisip sa mga worldly songs nila. Pag naririnig ko na, sa ako naalala. How about this? Tell me about this. Okay, sana lang. Because this is the goal of the enemy. The enemy will watch closely and will take every advantage of circumstances to what? Degrade the truth by the introduction of undignified demonstrations. None of these demonstrations are to be encouraged. The precious truths given us are to be spoken in all solemnity and with what? Sacred awe. Tatanda niya, dapat may solemnity siya at may sacred awe. Hindi pala basta-basta na kumakanta o ano. How about this kind of song? Is it inspirational? Is that inspirational degrading? Nakita niyo yung anger, nakita niyo yung hardness ng music. Yeah. So, how about this kind of music? Is it appropriate for us? Tell me if this is degrading or inspirational. Circumstance is as hopeless as can
that degrading or inspirational? Very inspiring, very inspirational. Sinasabi niya pa, at the moment na hopeless ka na, yun ang panahon na God wants to hear you sing. That is the very time God wants to hear you pray. When you pray, that becomes your music to God. When you sing songs to God, that becomes your prayer to God. Kaya very, very delightful sa Panginoon na naririnig yung music natin because that really, what? That really is so comforting for Him to hear us. Because mas nakita niya yung connection na meron tayo sa Kanya. So be very careful on what you're listening to. And last but not the least, it should be clear, not confused or disguised. It should be clear, not confused or disguised. Let me ask you, how long you here are gentlemen? Raise your hand. Gentlemen. Ladies. I'm just making clear, no? Kung ba may confused sa atin dito or disguised. But the music that you should listen to, it should be clear, not confused. Hindi dapat siya nako-confuse, no? Hindi siya nako-confuse sa atin. Pag sinabi natin, religious, not because it is religious, it's already appropriate for us. It should not be confusing. It should have a clear message for each other. It should be very clear. Godly music will contain lyrics and instrumentation that are full of clarity, beauty and dignity, worthy the praise and worship of God. The genre will not cloud or confuse the what? The message. It should not confuse the message. Messages to young people, page 294. When human beings sing with the spirit and understanding, ano ibig sabihin nun? Yun yung sinasabi ko, spirit and in truth. Pag meron mong spirit and understanding, heavenly musicians take up the strain and join in the song of thanksgiving. Isn't that beautiful? He who has bestowed, let it be used to His glory. Now, let me give you an example. Okay? Okay, are you ready? The devil will always use distractions, no? Now tell me, kayo na mismo mag-discern na to, may paparinig ako sa inyong music, iba-iba yung genre niya. Iba-iba yung genre niya, but it's the same song. Tell me, kayo na lang mismo mag-discern sa inyo, sa sarili niyo, if it is what? Meaningful or trivia? If it is untitled or worthy? If it is spiritual or carnal, if it is inspirational or degrading, is it clear or disguised and confused? Now, how about this song? In Christ alone, I place my trust. Is it clear or disguised? But if you will listen to the perfect harmony of that, it's very powerful music. It's very powerful music. I love that song. May problema sa refrain, no? Itama lang yung tempo ng song, it's still the same. Perfect. How about this?
Oh Lord, my God.
Ha? Kayo naman mismo mag-discern. May maririnig lang kayong salita dyan.
I see the stars. It works. I hear the rolling.
Is it wonderful?
Thy power throughout the universe displayed.
How about this?
Then sings my soul, my Savior God to me. How great thou art.
No problem. Nakita niyo rin din? Iba, iba? How about this?
There sings my soul, my Savior, God to me.
Sa church, iba?
Already. And therefore, my God, how great.
How about this? Tignan niya, yung sensuality niya.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God.
Ask you if you will go with what the world is telling you. I would still go of what you know that's set the Lord. Now let me ask you, my friends, bakit napaka-importante pag-aralan natin ang music in these end times? In this generation, what needs to be corrected? Hindi lang dahil pagpatanin natin sa langit ay tama dapat ang music natin, kundi meron siyang special role in the end times. It has a great role in the end times. And I invite you to open your Bibles with me in Daniel chapter 3. And then, i-re-relate ko sa inyo yung connection nito sa Revelation 13. Because whether you like it or not, the devil will always make a counterfeit in the end times. Are you there, Daniel chapter 3? Okay. Can you read, Kim? Verse 3. Simulan mo na lang ang verse 2.
Tagalog?
Sige.
Chapter
3,
verse
2. Yeah. Chapter 3, verse 2. Tapos tuloy-tuloy ka verse 4.
Na magkagayoy, nagsugo si Nabucodonosor na hari upang pisan ang mga satrapa, ang mga kinatawan at ang mga gobernador, ang mga hukong, ang mga taga-ingat yaman, ang mga kasangguni, ang mga pinuno at ang lahat na pinuno sa mga lalawigan upang magsiparoon sa pagtatalaga ng larawan na itinayunin na Nabucodonosor na hari. Na magkagayoy, mga satrapa, ang mga kinatawan at ang mga gobernador, ang mga hukong, ang mga tag-iingat yaman, ang mga kasungguni, ang mga pinuno at lahat ng pinuno sa mga lalawigan ay nagpisan sa pagtatalaga ng larawan na itinayo ni Nabucodonosor na hari. At sila'y nagsitayo sa harap ng larawan na itinayo ni Nabucodonosor.
Now, verse 4. Ba't sinin yung verse 4, ha?
Na magkagayoy, ang tagapagtanyag ay sumigaw ng malakas. Sa inyo'y iniuutos o mga bayan, mga bansa, at mga wika. Na sa anumang oras na inyong marinig ang tunog ng korneta, ng flauta, ng alpa, ng sambuko, ng salterio, ng gaita, at lahat ng sarisaring panugtog, kayo'y mga patirapa at magsisamba sa larawang ito na itinayo ni Nabucodonosor.
Okay. Thank you, Kim. Napansin niyo, mga kapatid, if you would notice verse 4, ito'y para kanino? In all kinds of people, in all kinds of language, in all kinds of nations. If you would be very, very observant with the verse, sabi dito, then an herald cried aloud. Ano sabi? To you it is commanded. Isn't that familiar with us? Isn't that a familiar verse? Na kung saan meron daw crying aloud. Kanino daw binibigay? People, nations, and languages. Aren't you familiar that this is a counterfeit worship? Bakit? Open your Bible to Revelation 14. Revelation 14, para mas mapatunayan natin that the devil is really making what? A counterfeit worship here. Sabi sa verses 6 and 7. Especially verse 7, no? Ang connection na lang yung last part ng 6, sabi dito, having the everlasting lasting gospel to preach unto them that what? Dwell on the earth and to what?
Every nation.
Have you read that? Daniel 3? Everyone, kindred, and tongue, and people, ano sinabi? Saying with a what? Loud voice. Fear God and give glory to Him. Ano sabi ng Daniel 3 verse 4? Then an herald cried aloud,
To you, it is commanded, all people, nations, and languages. And they worship the golden image. But in Revelation 14, God wants us to worship Him, to fear God, and give glory to Him. Have you seen na merong importance ito sa kapanahunan natin ngayon? Now the question, ano ang signal for them? What is the very signal for them to worship the golden image? According to verse 5. Music. It is music. Kaya, hindi ko pwedeng gawing trivial ang music na to because it really has a great part in the end times. And the devil will always work out his counterfeit for us not to be led in the right kind of worship and music for God. Are you familiar with the Indiana Camp scenario? Napasa niyo na ba yung Indiana Camp na nangyari sa panahon nila Ellen White? Alam niyo nangyari doon? They had this social gathering. Tapos, ang ginawa ng mga kabataan at that time, nagkaroon ng loud music, and as if it is a roar of war. And Ellen White was able to see it in a vision. Hindi talaga siya naka-witness nun. Kundi may naka-witness nun, nakita niya in the vision. Alam niyo sabi doon? Ni-report kasi sa kanya what happens to these young people. Yung mga music nila ay nag-lead sa kanila sa wrong kind of spirit. And this is the possession of the devil according to what she said. And she was able to recognize na in the last days, it is the same thing. Pagdating po sa huling kapanahonan, music will be a very great issue in the church of God. Especially with the young people. Can be very careful pag nagkaroon tayo ng social gatherings. What kind of music do we listen to? Because kung nangyari yun sa Indiana Camp at nagkaroon ng matinding problema, may mga namatay na tao because of the music alone. And even in the time of Israel, yung nag-worship sa golden image, yun ang nag-lead sa kanila na, magalit ang Panginoon, nag-crack yung lupa at maraming kinain. It's because of their wrong kind of music. Do you remember Korah? Music has a great part in the end times. We are now discussing the biblical essence of music. If Daniel 3 have a counterfeit worship, Daniel 3 is related to Revelation 13. It is creating a counterfeit worship. Let me tell you, if there is a Godhead, there's a Trinity, there's also a counterfeit Trinity. According to Revelation 13, what are those? First one is the dragon, the second one is the first beast, and the third one is the third beast. Let me tell you that this first and second beast will work out something in the end times as it happened in Daniel 3. At anong magiging hujat? Music. I would like to tell you later on why music ang pinakagagamitin because it is really having a character of true worship. Now let me give you parallels of Daniel 3 and Revelation 13 for us to see ganun talaga kabigat ang essence ng music in the end times. And I would like to appeal to you that let us be serious about this matter. Kasi hindi basta-basta to. First one, I would like you to see who rules in Daniel 3. It's also Babylon, tama? Babylon rules the world. And the same way, pagdating po sa uling kapanahonan, ang Babylon ang mag-rule sa mundong ito. What is the meaning of Babylon? Confusion. Confusion. Another one. That is the first one. Babylon rules the world. The second one is this. The king creates an image to honor himself. Ginawa ba yun sa Revelation 13? Gagawin ba yun? Yes. If you will read Revelation 13, he will create an image to what? To glorify himself, to worship himself. Sinabi pa nga doon, and the world wonder and worship the image or the beast. Is this a coincidence? No, it is not. Another one is this. He demands what? Worship of himself. The dragon The first beast and the second beast will demand worship for himself. It's the same way as Nebuchadnezzar demand worship for himself. The fourth one is this. Medyo mabigat. The penalty for refusal is what? Is the pain of death. Ipapapatay. Diba sa Daniel 3, pinapatay sila? Nilagay sila saan? Sa purno. Sa purno. Now let me ask you, who are the main key or the key people, the key persons in the story of Daniel 3? Sadra, or let me say, Mishael, what, Azariah, and Ananias. Why are they the only people who stood for the right? Because they are the only people who have relationship with God. Now let me tell you, ano sa tingin nyo sila? Matatanda na? They are also kabataan. If that happened in the end times, or in the Daniel 3, I believe in the end times, ang mga kabataan din ang tatawagin ng Panginoon na tatayo para sa tamang music, para sa tamang worship. And can you just imagine, nasa kapatagan kayo, lahat ng kalyuko ang makikita mo, well, for sure, ang makikita mo kung sino'y nakatayo. Distinguish mo talaga na meron tatlong tao doon na ano, na nakatayo. They are not worshiping the golden image. I believe there will really minorities that will follow the right kind of music, genuine relationship, and genuine worship in the end times. Now, my question for you, for each one of us, saan kaya tayo dun? Sa magpapatira pa? Or sa tatayo? Yung tipong kahit na ikakapatay mo na, o ipapatay ka pa ng tao, you will still follow what does say. At itong nakakalungkot, according to Daniel 3 in Revelation 13, all the world bows down and worships the image. Tama? Are you seeing that the world is worshiping music at this moment? Whether you like it or not, all around us are filled with music. Kahit pagdating mo sa jeep, ayaw mo makinig nun. Pagbunta mo sa bus, ayaw mo makinig nun. Pero bakit na doon yung music? Because the devil really wants to disturb us, to distract us. That if we are really enamored with Christ, yung personal relationship natin sa Panginoon, yun ang magbibigay sa atin sa mga world music. I would like to testify of that. Nung iniwan ko po ang rock and roll music, ang hirap makinig ng tama diksi, maririnig mo ang dati mong music. You know what? Doon sa bed ko, katabi kasi siya ng bintana. At sa bintana, maririnig mo sa labas. At sa second deck ako, yung pinsan ko nasa first deck. Ang pinapakinggan ng music ng pinsan ko ay ano, rock and roll. Now, kung ikaw nababasa ng Bible, makaka-concentrate ka ba? No! Tapos ang maririnig mo pa sa likod mo ay music din ng kamunduhan na naririnig mo sa kapitbahay. Makaka-concentrate ka ba? You know what? When you really pray for God for concentration, for focus, God will make you deaf of those worldly music. When I really concentrate myself to God, kahit gaano pa kahirap magbasa, God will help me because He makes sure that when I'm focused to Him, He will also help me to be focused with the worship that I am having. And is that a natural thing? No. It is only God who can do that for us. Hindi natin kaya yun sa ating sarili. Hindi natin yung kaya sa ating sarili. Now, according to Daniel 3 in Revelation 13, what is the very prompter of music? Or worship? It is music. The worship prompter is music. So now, is this really a coincidence? Never a coincidence. The prompter is music. Now, let me tell you this. Bakit music ang gagamitin? Why music is the very thing that the devil will use to prompt us in worshiping Him? Bakit po? Kaya mo i-give up ang movies, tama? Madaling i-give up ang movies, ng video games. Madaling i-give up ang wrong kind of food. madaling i-give up ang ano, wrong kind of deportment. Pero bakit napakahirap i-give up ang music? Ha? Huh? See, give me an answer, please. Help me on this. Bakit? I would like to be personal with you. I would like to connect with you. Bakit music ang pinakamahirap i-give up? Kahit sabihin mo ano, kahit sabihin mo hindi ka magaling sa music, music is still part of our lives. And whether we like it or not, it will really be what? Ringing to each one of us because it is part of who we are. Music is part of who we are. Pagdating mo sa movies, may music. Pagdating mo sa radio, may music. Pagdating mo sa mabalita, meron pa rin sound effects at may music pa rin. All the world has music. When you go to the planetariums, tama? Pagkakalagalan natin kanina, it is proclaiming what? Music. Even our DNA has music. Because music is built in us. At ang gagawin ng kaway, he wants to distort it so that we will have a distorted worship with God. Now, I would like you to see this. According to Wolfgang Stefani, isa po siyang director ng music. And he's one of the General Conference prominent authors with regards to music. And notes, music as an incommunicable force. Ito sabi niya. Talk of a world social formation. Tingnan niya yung relation niya talaga sa Daniel 3 and also Revelation 13. And the possibility of a strategy for global moralization were no longer considered a figment of speculative imagination. Bakit hindi na siya speculative imagination? Because it becomes real. Why? Listen to this. Because of its universal availability and acceptance. Available ba music everywhere? Yes. Popular music was identified, listen to this, as the what? Major rallying point for the what? For the formation of an what? International youth culture. Sino na-distort ng Daniel 3? Ano? For sure, yung mga tao rin at the time and the youth will be distorted. The devil would like to target the youth. At nowadays, he will use music to distort or to create an international youth culture based on what? Common, worldwide tastes and values. Anong taste mo sa music? For sure, it has also have what? A similarity with other people. Could it be that by fostering a homogenized global musical style, a style that is increasingly visible in the what? Christian music culture, the stage is being what? Set for a global religious identity response. Sinong ginagamit ng kaway sa music ngayon? Kabataan. Who are the main proponents of music that is powerful in the young people? It's also kabataan. Why? Because it is really creating an international youth culture. A response that will allow people of all nations, all religious backgrounds to say, nakita niyo parallel niya sa Daniel D. To say, yes, this is my music. You have your music. This is who I am. Your music, your life. Your life, your music. This is my music for being happy and religious, and I am part of it. Listen to what the last words are. I am right at home now. Is this a coincidence? No. It is very crucial nowadays. Kaya po kailangan natin piliin ang tama ang music natin because in the end times, it is a very crucial prompter of kinds of worship. Is it the genuine or the counter? Hindi pa rin basta-basta ganun na lang ang pinapakinggan natin ang music. But rather, we really need to make sure that we are in the right concept and principle of music. And last but not the least, this is what I love. The revelation, the connection of Daniel 3 and Revelation 13. Though people will worship God through wrong kind of music, I assure you, it might be very hard to give up your all kind of music. Your music right now might be very hard to give up. But let me tell you this. When you place it in the hands of God, He will really help you to stand. Because number 7, the parallel of Daniel 3 and Revelation 13 is this. The Son of God is what? Is with them who follows Him and delivers them. Amen? When you really love God, when you really love to worship God, when it is your highest goal to worship and glorify God, I assure you, it will really help you to stand on right what though the heavens may fall. Hindi tatayo si King Joshua para sa akin. I will stand on my word. I will be accountable on my what? Relationship with God. On my conviction. Magkakahiwalay-hiwalay tayo. In the end times, alam mo ba yun? Ang tanong, pag nag-drop ng mundo ng music for worship, where will we be found? Saan kaya tayo matatagpuan? Mga kapatid, I have a very deep concern for each of our souls. If you will still be compromising music, I tell you, it is high time not to compromise it, because it is high time to what? Anchor ourselves in the genuine worship. It is high time. Time will come. Time will come. The devil will really prompt beautiful music, religious music, yet in the wrong kind of music. Now the question is, do we really know what is genuine and what is not? What is 1:3 and what is 2:4? What is glorifying God and what is degrading the image of God? And let me tell you, if there will be one person that we are going to follow in this world, hindi ang music director sa akin. Hindi rin si Brother Robert. Hindi rin yung youth leaders nito. Sino ang susundan ninyo sa buhay ninyo sa mundong ito? Who's the only person? Jesus Christ. And don't you know that Jesus Christ is the best example for music? I like how the person a while ago observed. Meron ba talagang world standard and religious standard? I would disagree with that. Because I would like you to see, yes, we are failing with music, but let me tell you that Jesus Christ is the best example of it. He will proclaim, He has set an example what is the right kind of music. Let me tell you, let me read to you, Desire of Ages 73, paragraph 3. Read this with me as we close. This is my last quotation. Can you read it for me? Ready, go.
Jesus carried into His day your cheerfulness and talk. It requires much patience and spirituality to bring back the religion into the whole night in the worship and bear mysteries of worldliness. Yet, in the eyes of the Lord, the Lord of God, He is His spirit and our sins and hope.
Now listen to the, now read the next line. He was what? He was never so full of what? Worldly care as to have no time or thought for what? Heavenly things. Now, I would like you to notice this. This is where Jesus Christ is an example. Often, He expressed the what? The gladness of His heart by singing worldly songs. By singing what? Singing psalms and heavenly songs. Wala ka makikita na nilapatan niya ng worldly songs. Though in the generation of Jesus Christ sa mga Hudyo, meron silang worldly songs at that time. It is best set for each one of us because God knows that if we really wanted to glorify Him, He will help us. He will help us in the right kind of music. Often, the dwellers in Nazareth heard His voice raised in praise and thanksgiving to whom? To God. He had communion with heaven in what? In song. And I like this one. And as His companions complained of weariness from labor, they were cheered by the sweet melody from His lips. Would you like to have that? Na merong naboboring, merong na-stress na mga tao, pero when they hear your voice, they find relief. They find peace. This is what God wants us to do. His praise, I really love this. His praise seemed to banish the evil angels, and like incense, filled the place with what? Fragrance. The minds of his what? Bearers were carried away from earthly exile to heavenly home. My friends, God is calling us nowadays to set the example of Jesus Christ, to express our songs in singing psalms and heavenly songs, because saan pa ba natin isiset ang music natin rather than preparing ourselves for the soon coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, my friends, I would like to talk to you right now. I know many of you might be giving up many things in music. Naintindihan ko yun. It might be very hard to give up because even I have given up music for 3 years. And hindi ko pa natutunan agad itong mga principles na ito. But God has led me to the truth because I wanted to glorify Him. Hindi basta-basta mga kapatid. But when you really wanted to glorify God, He will give the best music. You know what? When I scrutinize my music, tinignan ko laptop ko, tinignan ko mga music ko, ang MP3 ko, ang iPad, MP3 player. Walang natira sa music ko. Galit na galit ako sa Panginoon. Panginoon, ganito ba? Kung natutunan ko ang tamang music, tamang prinsipo ng music, wala kang ititira sa akin. Nag-bargain ako sa Panginoon, nagalit ako sa Panginoon. Pero alam niyo, nagpabuti ng Panginoon. When you are really seeking for the right, for the principle, for the right music for God, I tell you, God has given me more than the best music that I've ever asked for. Meron palang tamang yung music. Ang mahirap na sa atin, tamad tayo maghanap. Tama? Tamad lang talaga tayo. Pero when we are seeking for it, kusa na lang magbubuo sa atin. Babagyuin tayo ng tamang music because God will really provide. So, when we ask of it. Now, some of you might be giving up things right now. But it's not yet too late. It's not yet too late. God is calling us to be musical workers. At the closing now, my laptop, I would like to make an appeal for each one of us. I would like to make a call. I would like to invite you to bow your heads and close your eyes also. Every eyes closed, please. Do not open your eyes. This is a personal call. Close your eyes, please. Bow your heads. At this moment of time, close your eyes, please. Bow your heads. I would like to make an appeal for each one of you. Now that you have learned the right principles of music, and you have understood that we really need to take heed of our music because it has a great bearing in the end times, especially in heaven. Now at this point of time, no one is looking at you. I ask you if you are this person who would like to give up what is going between you and God, and you would like to be enamored with the right kind of music at this point of time, I invite you to please stand on your feet. I invite you to stand on your feet. Hindi ko kayo in-invite because I would like to force you. But it is your commitment with God. And another one. If you would like to be a musical warrior for God at this moment of time, my friends, it is high time. Nakakapagod na makinig ng mamaling music. We wanted to go home, yet our music is not going home. If you are this person who would like to be a musical warrior at this point of time, you still close your eyes, you still bow your heads. And if you are this person who would like to commit yourself as a music warrior for God, I invite you to open your eyes and come in front, and I would like to make a special prayer for you. If you are this person who would like to be a music warrior, starting here at Beacon and starting at your home and starting in your place, you would like to commit yourself to God, it might be very hard, but God will help you. So thank you so much for this. Now I've seen these things. Hindi niyo po ito ginagawa para sa akin that you're doing this for God. I know it's very hard because time will come. The devil will still pull you in the wrong kind of music. But one thing is for sure, when you really is upward with God, He will help you to be in the right upward music. Now at this moment, I would like to invite you to our hands as we will commit ourselves to God. Father, nakakapagod na po, mahirap. Napapusik ako, hindi nakakaluan natin sa inyong pangalan. At meron din Panginoon, ito yung hindi nakapagkatawalan kasi marami yung pagkakataon na sinisira namin ang iyong pangalan sa mga pusin ang pinapakinggan namin. Akala namin tama, akala namin nangangabuti ito dahil kasi ito ay Kristiyanong musika. Pero ngayon, napagtanto namin, Panginoon, na hindi pala ito tama. May mga music pala na hindi ka napagtapon sa iyong banal na presensya. At narin ko ang aking mga kaibigan, nais nilang maging music warrior starting sa kanilang sarili, ganun din sa kanilang pamilya, at ganun din sa buong bin. At kung saan man sila, Panginoon, tulungan niyo sila maging music warrior. Tumayo sila, Panginoon, dito at nababasa niyo ang kanilang mga puso't isipan ngayon. Tumatayo sila para sa inyo. At tulungan niyo sila, Panginoon, na tumayo sa uling kapanahon at alam ko maghiwalay-hiwalay kami after ng viewers. Magkakaroon ng peer pressure, magkakaroon ng challenges, pero Panginoon, tulungan sila. Akbayan sila, Panginoon, at tulungan sila maitama ang kanilang music. Lalo higit, magbigay luwalhati lamang sa inyo sa mga musika. Panginoon, hindi ito madali. Dahil ito ay konti ng Lord. Pero alam ko, Panginoon, na tutulungan ko sila. At sa panahon, Panginoon, na kami magkakaiwalay, makita nawa kami maging kagaya ni Mishael, Ananias at Azariah, na tayo para sa katotohanan, kahit hindi nyo pa kami iligtas sa purno ng ahon. Dahil alam namin na pag kami ay tumayo sa tama, kailanman kami po ay may tatama sa inyong banal na hangas. Maraming salamat, Panginoon, dahil mayroong mga kamag-anak na nais na gawin. Tulungan sila, Panginoon, umakbang sa tama na sa inyong nakasusunod sa tiyan ay akbar din sa tama. Pagpalaan niyo po ka na ng desisyon, maraming salamat sa inyo po ang siguradahin. Nagagabayan sila at papalaksin sa prinsipyo nila. Purihin ang Panginoon kaya nagpag-tatay laman. Seliwan niyo po ang kanilang desisyon. Tulungan sila sa kanilang paglalakad sa mundo ito habang kami nalakas na kalakot. Ito po ang aming sa mga kanilang sa mga kanilang sa mga Jesus. God bless you.